He doesn't have freedom to adjust plays. It depends on the play we call. I mean, there's some plays we call where he can adjust. There's some plays we call that are straight running. So it depends on which one we call. But there are those that he is he checks with me. And, you know, you try to base it on simple things like most offenses do. But he's very knowledgeable of that. That's an asset that we have with him, that he's very comfortable with that.
Is it safe to say that that the offense is different, you know, under Jake than it would have been under Jacob? Like, Jacob might have had more latitude in that type of situation you're describing.
I wouldn't say that. I wouldn't say that. You're saying that Jacob Eason would have more latitude than Fromm?
Yeah, on it.
I don't know. I mean, they both went through entire camp doing the same plays and scripts and same things. We call the same plays with them. We check the same plays with them. We don't say these are Eason plays, these are Fromm plays. I mean, they're both very intellectual guys. Jake's a little more exceptional for a freshman as far as knowledge. Eason, in his second year, has picked up everything, is able to check and do things. Fromm did a little more of that stuff in high school, so he's a little more advanced than a normal freshman would be. I'm not saying compared to Eason, I'm just saying than a normal freshman. So they both do a good job of that, and quarterbacks are expected to do that. That's the advantage of having a smart quarterback, is he's supposed to get you in the right play.
Kirby couldn't help but notice that Sony was out there today, but he wasn't really doing the reps that he normally does. Is he got something going on? I noticed he was getting taped late in the game Saturday.
I think he's going to be fine. I mean, he's got a small ankle or something, but we expect him to be fine. We're just limiting his reps and hoping he's able to go Saturday. We think he'll be able to.
Kirby, when it comes to the run game, has it been a conscious effort to try and do more out of the shotgun to maybe soften up the box a little bit?
Well, it's been a conscious effort to loosen the box. It doesn't have to be gun. I mean, I think most of the time you open formations up, obviously the gun helps you. Anytime you're going to throw RPOs, it helps to be from the gun because it's hard to do that from under center. Mm-hmm. So the conscious effort has been to loosen up, but not necessarily the shotgun. But I think that the two go hand in hand. You got to be able to block on the perimeter, to run on the perimeter. So we got to improve in that area. And It's a challenge every week to run the ball. I mean, look at teams running it on us. It's hard to do. So it's not just a given that you can go out there and run it. You have to earn every yard you get when it comes to that. The good thing is we've got a good stable of backs to try to accomplish that with.
What's impressed you the most with DeAndre Swift to put him in the position that he's put himself in the last two games?
Just his maturity. I mean, he's very similar to Andrew Thomas. He's a very mature kid. He picks it up the first time. He doesn't need two reps. He understands the game. He's got great instincts, great hands. I mean, you can put him in the slot. You can put him in the backfield. You can put him on kickoff coverage. You can do anything with the guy, and he kind of gets it. And that's why when he was injured earlier in camp, we wanted to get him fixed. We knew he was going to be a player. He didn't need the reps. He needed to be healthy to play. So when we sent him to Philly to see the doctors, he got to go up there and get well and came back home.
Kirby, you mentioned Andrew Thomas. How has he progressed in his first couple of games here as a college player?
I think he's getting more confidence. You know, he's very quiet. He's a good leader. I think the better guys he plays against, he gains more confidence, which is very valuable before he gets into the bigger games coming down the road. He needs to establish some confidence. And he gets to go against pretty good guys every day in practice. So that's an advantage, too.
Is there anything specific you're doing to try and limit penalties after?
Yeah, we've always talk about penalties. We post penalties every day in our meetings, and I just laugh because of last year we were one of the least penalized teams, and now we're leading. And it's always funny to me when you look at stats, because they can say what you want them to say. Sometimes the most aggressive teams in the country are most penalized, and they have the best teams. And we certainly feel like we've been aggressive on special teams, and we've had some penalties in those areas. We've had some unfortunate ones with hands to the face that we've got to – I don't necessarily call all of them undisciplined. You know, you think of your team being undisciplined and they have a lot of penalties. Some of those penalties are not undisciplined. They're aggressive. And I don't go after aggressive penalties all the time because I think you can coach caution into your players. But we bring it to their attention, and we show them a lot of stats on penalties.
How did the offensive line look this week?